I'm reading a poem of the Nativity, coming from Luke chapter 2. 'Twas a night long ago, and so far, far away, when a young bright-eyed couple went on a vacay. Now, this wasn't so much of a leisurely trip, but one that was commanded by the government. For the one who ruled over the place where they lived said all had to go, men, women, and kids, and return to the town where their families were from, the place of the dad, not the place of the mom. So the couple packed up and set off on a mule and went to his hometown to follow the rule. There's a twist to this story. I can't be meek and mild. The woman in this story was definitely with child. So as you can guess, the trip was quite long, and it seemed that all and everything did go wrong. For once they arrived at their city of choice, they found nothing there in which they might rejoice. The inns were all full, there were no places to stay, and the woman was about to give birth any day. But just when they were about to lose hope, one inn owner offered a small way to cope. "You can stay in the barn," the gentleman said, "where the cows and the sheep and the pigs all do tread." The couple went out to camp in hay and earth, and you see, before long, the woman gave birth. The child was a boy. He was born in a shed, and they had to make a food trough into a small bed. She wrapped him in blankets. She wrapped him up tight. Then she laid him in bed and kissed him with delight. Meanwhile, in the country, there were shepherds and sheep, and since it was night, they were trying to sleep. But then, out of nowhere, the sky filled with light, and the shepherds were overcome with a great fright. An angel called to them, crying out, "Do not fear. I have some good news. It's the reason I'm here. A baby's been born, and he's a pretty big deal. He's come for all people to save and to heal. Go now and find him. You'll know him this way. He'll be wrapped up in blankets and lying in hay." Then, again out of nowhere, more angels appeared and filled the whole sky, which must have been sort of weird. They all joined in singing, their voices they raised to sing to the Lord with the highest praise. A short while later, the angels took flight, and the shepherds, well, they set off into the night. They left from the hills and went toward the city in order to find this much lauded baby. And once they arrived, they did find the shed, and there he lay inside the pig trough, or baby bed. The shepherds told all the angels' proclamation gave about this dear baby and how he would save. His mother sat and watched, though her part isn't done yet, for she vowed then and there it's something she would never forget. The shepherds then left to go back to their sheep and found themselves with a joy full and complete. And this is our story. This is where it all ends. Or maybe it's actually where everything begins.